So one thing you can do in After Effects is create some pretty cool animated backgrounds. So in this video, I'm going to show you guys how to create this cool background inside After Effects using the built-in effects. And as always, if you are a patron on my Patreon page, you can download this free Moger and template to use in your own projects. If you do want to become a patron to support this channel, a link is down in the video description if you are interested. So I'm inside Adobe After Effects, and the first thing we're going to do is create a composition. I'm going to go up to Composition, New Composition. I'm going to name this Animated Background. And under Presets, I'm just going to choose the 1920 by 1080 preset, 29 frames a second. The only other setting I would change is the duration. Just make sure that it's 30 seconds long. And then click OK. Okay, next we're gonna create a new solid, and this will house our coloring effect. Next, just go up to Layer, New Solid. I'm gonna name it Colors, that way we know what's inside of it. Click on Make Comp Size, and then click OK. Next, we're gonna go over to Effects and Presets and type in for Color Gradient, and click and drag this to your solid. Now you'll notice that these four color points are added to the solid. You can customize your colors by going into Effects Controls and choose your custom colors. These can be the colors of your personal brand or your favorite colors that you want to use in your video project. So I'm going to set my colors here. And then one note is that there's a blend option. So if you change this value, you'll see how they're blended together. You can see as you increase this value, they're more blended. And as you decrease, they're more individualized here. All right, so the next step is to actually animate them. Inside Effects Controls, you'll notice that you have some keyframes next to the point values. What I recommend doing is take your playhead, move it to the beginning of the composition, and then make keyframes on 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, and 0.4. Go out to about 10 seconds, and then inside the composition panel, you can just move these points around to kind of make them move a little bit. We're just looking for some subtle movements, but feel free to align these in different positions in the composition panel. Then I'm going to move my playhead to around 20 seconds, and then just move these around a little bit more to different positions in your composition. And then finally, I'm gonna go to the end of my composition. I'm gonna click on my layer in the timeline panel and click U. And then what I'm gonna do is actually just marquee and select these first keyframes that you made here. Hit Command or Control C on a PC. And then at the end of the composition, just hit Command V. Now we'll paste those keyframes. I'm gonna add some easing to these keyframes. To do that, I'm just gonna marquee select these middle keyframes here by just clicking and dragging, and then right click, go to Keyframe Assistance, Easy Ease. Keyboard shortcut is F9. And then for the beginning keyframes, I'm gonna select them, right click and go to Keyframe Assistant, Easy Ease Out. And then at the end, I'm just gonna marquee select these keyframes, right click on them, go to Keyframe Assistance, Easy Ease In. Easy Ease In eases into the keyframe, and Easy Ease Out eases out of the keyframe. So the colors, as you notice, will kind of ease out and ease in at the end. One other thing we're gonna add to this to kind of enhance it a little bit is a line pattern. To do that, grab your pen tool, and then at the top right, you'll see it, the stroke option. What I'm gonna do is just click on the color, make it white. I'm gonna change my stroke to around 6 pixels, and then you'll have a pen icon as your tool. And what I'm gonna do is just gonna click one point and click another point to make a line. Now we have a line in our program monitor. I'm gonna zoom out by hitting Command Dash. Then I'm gonna grab my selection tool by clicking V. I'm just gonna click back on the line, click G to bring up your pen tool, click on the vertices, and then you can click and drag these points to kind of move them outside of the composition. I'm gonna grab my selection tool again and click and drag this point to just move it out. That way your two points are on the outside here. Now that we have that set, I'm just gonna go to my view and go to fit. So now we have this one single line, but how do we actually make it as a pattern? What you can do is actually use what's called repeaters. And this essentially just repeats a graphic or shape inside your After Effects timeline. To add a repeater to this line, what I'm gonna do is untwirl it in the timeline panel and then click the little triangle button next to the add. And then you'll notice that there's a repeater section. Just click on that and now you'll see that a repeater is added. Now under the repeater, there's a lot of different options that you can choose from. You can increase the number of copies. So I'm gonna change this value up quite a bit, maybe to 100. And then offset actually slides it over. So if we just drag this to the left, we can actually slide it over. That way they cover the whole composition. And then under transform repeater, this is where you can actually transform it. The position kind of acts as the spacing in between the lines. So as you can see, as we make this smaller here, the lines are closer together. You can also play with the opacity. So I'm going to knock this down a little bit so it's a little bit more blended in here. And the last step is to actually animate this. I recommend adding a transform effect to this line graphic. So to do that, I'm just going to click on this line graphic, go back up to my effects and presets window, and type for transform. It's available under the distort options. I'm just going to click and drag this to my shape layer. And then what you can do is just keyframe the position, move it over a little bit, go to the end of your timeline here at 30 seconds, and then just slide this over. Once you slide it over, you might have to adjust how many copies there are. So just easily go back into your copies and just increase the number of copies. And then also slide it over. Make the offset maybe negative 200 here. And now when we play this back, you'll see that we have a nice animated textured line, colorful background. Now, if you want to see how I actually take this and maybe use it inside a motion graphics template, I am hosting a live stream. Once that becomes available, that video and link to join will be right up there. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.